Hare Krishna. When we make God our friend, we become our own friend. We are often our worst enemies. When we get some lucky break, when we get some good opportunities, we often fail to tap them. We just let them slide by, not doing anything constructive. And in this way, if we consider who causes us the greatest harm, yes, there are people who are enemies who hurt us, but we hurt ourselves the most by giving too much time to small things, by letting trivialities distract us from that which is important for us. So, how can we stop being our own enemies? Krishna talks about how within us is something which makes us our own enemies. In 6.5, he says, Uddhare dhatmana atmanam, natmanam avasadayet, atmaivaya atmano bandhur, atmaiva ripuratmanaha. So he says, elevate yourself with yourself. Don't degrade yourself with yourself. Because you are your own friend as well as you are your own enemy. You can be your own friend and you can be your own enemy. And when are we our friend and when we are our enemy? That he mentioned in 6.6. Next verse, that is, Bandhur atma atmanastasya yenatmaiva atmanajitaha anatmanastu shatrutve varte tatmaiva shatruvat. That as long as we stay our own friends, that means as long as our mind is uncontrolled, the mind stays our enemy, and because we can't control the mind, it controls us, and then by letting it control us, we become our own enemies. But if we can learn to control our mind, then the mind becomes our friend, and we also become our friends. But how can we control the mind? That Krishna says in 6.7, Jitatmanaha prashantasya paramatma samahitaha shitoshna sukadukheshu tathamanapamanayo. That Jitatmanaha, that the person's mind becomes controlled, prashantasya, becomes very deeply peaceful. When paramatma samahitaha, when one attains the super soul, when one attains, one lives in constant contact with the Supreme. Krishna repeatedly in the Bhagavad-Gita says that manmana bhavamad bhakto manmana, fix your mind on me. So when can we fix our mind on someone? And Krishna says, fix it devotionally. When we understand that Krishna is our greatest friend, he's our greatest well-wisher. The Krishna has talked about it earlier in the Bhagavad-Gita 5.29. Surudam sarva-bhutanam, that he is our greatest well-wisher. So when we understand this point, that Krishna is our greatest friend, and then we try to stay always connected with Krishna, stay always in his presence, then we are no longer so overwhelmed by our mind. Rather, we move forward purposefully in spite of our mind, staying connected with Krishna, and that connection gradually brings about pacification and purification of the mind. And that's how we go beyond the distresses of life. That is how we become our own friend, by not aggravating life's problems and by maximally utilizing life's opportunities. So, making Krishna our friend means learning to harmonize our life with his plan, his purpose, his guidelines, which calm our mind and thus help us to tap our potentials, making us our own friend. Thank you. Hare Krishna.